Hello friends, today we will discuss the withdrawal of Burundi from International Criminal Court. Burundi, an African country, withdrew from International Criminal Court, becoming the first country to leave International Criminal Court on October 27, 2017. Last year, 2016, some countries in African Union, especially South Africa, Gambia and Burundi, they announced that they are withdrawing from International Criminal Court because International Criminal Court is only targeting the African continent by inquiring only criminal cases in Africa, leaving aside other continents of the world. So they expressed their unwillingness to continue in International Criminal Court, and this decision of these countries were also supported by African Union. But however, out of three countries, two countries, say South Africa as well as Gambia, they have changed their mind and they decided to continue in International Criminal Court. South Africa will retain its membership in International Criminal Court because South African Supreme Court has told the South African government to stay in ICC, not to leave ICC. Similarly, Gambia new president Mr. Barrow, he came and he changed the mind, and he also announced that Gambia will continue to stay in International Criminal Court. But the president of Burundi, Nkurunziza, he walked out of ICC. The reason was there was crime taking place in Burundi after 2015 when Nkurunziza got elected for the third term. In Burundi constitution, it is clearly written that a person cannot get elected for the third term. Only maximum two terms a person can be the president of Burundi. But Nkurunziza got re-elected for the third term in 2015. And because of this, there are increasing rebel movements against the president of Burundi. And he started using his repressive force to suppress the revolts against him. And that has resulted in crime against humanity according to International Criminal Court. Burundi has communicated before itself to United Nations that they are walking out of International Criminal Court. Now we should know the relation between International Criminal Court and United Nations. International Criminal Court is not an organ of United Nations. International Criminal Court is independent body. It is not an organ. It is not an organ of United Nations. So naturally, we have to make a comparison between the judicial organ of UN, that is International Court of Justice, and International Criminal Court. We will make a comparison between ICJ, which is one of the principal organ of United Nations, with ICC, which happens to be the first permanent criminal court of the world. Now, being a principal organ of United Nations, ICJ is a product of the UN Charter, which was signed in 1945, and ICJ started working from 1946 onwards. When we come to this International Criminal Court, it is an outcome of Rome Statute, which was signed in 1998 by 120 countries, and after ratification by 60 countries from July 1st 2002 onwards, ICC started functioning. ICC started working from 2002, ICJ started working from 1946 onwards. Now we'll come to the composition of International Court of Justice. How many judges are there in International Court of Justice? There are 15 judges in International Court of Justice. Whereas in International Criminal Court, there are 18 judges. Now, what is the term of these judges? International Court of Justice, a term means 9 years. And they can be reappointed after 9 years, for another 9 years. For instance, as of now, Justice Dalveer Bhandari is nominated for the second time by India. Earlier he was elected in 2012 and his term got over, and now he is nominated for the second time by India. When we come to ICC, the term is only 9 years, similar to that of ICJ. But the only difference is ICC judges are not re-elected. Only one time a person can be the judge of ICC. Now come to how the judges are elected. In ICJ, judges are elected by 2/3 majority, separately by United Nations General Assembly as well as UN Security Council. When we come to ICC, judges are elected by Assembly of State Party. What do you mean by Assembly of State Party? It is like United Nations General Assembly. So you have United Nations General Assembly in UN, you have the Assembly of State Party in International Criminal Court. So State Party here means members of ICC. So the Assembly of the members of ICC, they will elect the judge of ICC. Jurisdiction of ICJ. ICJ, they have two types of functions. One is they will resolve the dispute between the state parties based on the international law. And secondly, they used to give advices to the UN body, including the specialized organs of the United Nations. When we come to ICC, the jurisdiction is Rome Statute, which was coming into force from 2002 onwards. It speaks about four types of crimes which can be tried by ICC. Number one, genocide. Number two, crime against humanity. Number three, war crimes. And number four, crime of aggression. Crime of aggression was not defined in 2002. So only first three charges will come under the scope of ICC as of now. They have made a draft definition of crime of aggression in 2010. But to include this fourth crime, you have to ratify the Rome Statute by more than 30 members. Coming to ICJ, ICJ can try only states. They cannot try individuals, they cannot try private entities, and they cannot try any non-governmental organization. When we come to ICC, they can try individuals. However, these individuals who are tried by ICC will have to be the citizen of the state party, or the crime should have taken place within the territory of the member country, or even a non-member who is accepting the jurisdiction of ICC, their national, their citizen also can be tried by ICC. If supposing that there is a criminal charge against an individual who is not a citizen of the member country, then there is a provision. UN Security Council will make a resolution under Chapter 7 of UN Charter. Based on this resolution, ICC can try an individual who is not a citizen of the member country. So, non-member country citizen can also be tried by ICC, provided it should be backed by UN Security Council resolution. Coming to International Court of Justice, since it is not a criminal court, there is no prosecutor, which means suo moto, the court cannot take up any dispute. The disputing state, one or more disputing states, they have to request ICJ, then only ICJ can try the case. When we come to ICC, that there is an office, an independent office called as Office of the Prosecutor, OTP. This OTP is the only person who can bring the criminal cases before the ICC. The primary function of OTP is, OTP will do preliminary analysis of evidence, it will do preliminary investigation, and fitting cases will be posted before the pre-trial court. Now, after pre-trial court, the case will go to trial court. After trial court, it goes to appeal court. After appeal court, it goes to enforcement of the sentence. There are 192 countries in ICJ. There are 123 countries in ICC. There are 30 plus countries who have signed the Rome Statute, but they have not ratified Rome Statute. For example, Libya, Israel, Russia, US and Sudan, though they have signed, but they told that they are not going to ratify Rome Statute. Some 40 plus countries, neither they have signed Rome Statute nor they have ratified Rome Statute. Example, India, China. So, ICC cannot try an Indian citizen. It cannot try a Chinese citizen because India and China, they have not signed as well as they have not ratified the Rome Statute. Whether ICC's judgment is binding. Under Article 10, Clause 1 of the UN Charter, it is told that the ICJ's verdict is binding on the state parties. When you come to ICC, ICC is not having an independent enforcement mechanism. It has to definitely rely on the national courts. ICC is not going to replace the national court. ICC can act complementary to national court. They have to enforce only with the help of the national institutions. They don't have an independent enforcement mechanism. Thank you for watching this video, friends. For more videos, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.